Hello everyone. In this presentation, I am going to explain in detail about what to see in a radiograph before assessing a tooth for root canal treatment. I developed this digital radiograph of a hypothetical patient who complains of pain in mandibular posterior teeth region. Which tooth could be the reason for pain in this patient? I will let this image for a minute so that you all can look for findings that corresponds to the symptoms given by the patient. Also, you all can see and assess the findings which will be necessary before doing root canal treatment in this specific scenario. Caries in second molar, caries in third molar, restoration in first molar, secondary caries under the restoration in first molar, periapical lesion in second molar, periapical widening in first molar. Yes, there are more important findings which are hidden inside this radiograph. Let's dive deep into this radiograph and let's look what all will be seen from an endodontist point of view. I am Dr. Benin. I will make videos that will be useful for dentists and dental students. Kindly consider subscribing to my YouTube channel Smart Dentistry. Give a thumbs up and a comment if you like this video. Caries being the first finding that will fall in all our eyes. Caries in second and third molar, secondary caries under the restoration in first molar. Yes, we are all well trained to look into that. This presentation is beyond what is normal and beyond diagnosing dental caries. I am going to give explanation and how to identify many other important diagnostic features which are always missed while radiographic examination. First and foremost, we should look into the size of the pulp chamber. It is always said that if the size of the pulp chamber is large, then root canal treatment is going to be easy. Yes, access cavity preparation, locating the root canal orifice, and almost all the steps in root canal treatment are simplified by a large pulp chamber. Not only the size of the pulp chamber, pulpal horns also should be taken into consideration. More than evaluations before root canal treatment, while doing restorative procedures or caries excavation in vital tooth, pulp horn evaluation is the key to success. Next important feature that we should be looking is whether the pulp chamber is clear or it lodges a pulp stone. Pulp stones often complicates root canal treatment. Their removal may be difficult, complicating root canal orifice location and negotiation. So each tooth should be evaluated for the presence of pulp stones. Pulp stones or pulp calcifications are more common in old age and if there is an old restoration already done in that specific tooth. They always appear more radiopaque than the nearby areas or as an isolated radiopaque mass inside the pulp chamber. A good quality radiograph will always give some ideas about the number of root canals. Although they are not conclusive, radiographs should be evaluated carefully before initiation of root canal treatment. In this radiograph, in the distal root of first molar, we can see that the canal disappears suddenly. This feature is called as fast break. This is a typical finding often seen when a canal splits into two or more number of canals. Fast break is often seen in the distal roots of mandibular molars and in mandibular premolars, but it can occur in any tooth. Whenever there is a fast break, we should negotiate the canal very carefully and we should use a very flexible small size files to bypass or to negotiate that areas. If you are inserting a bigger size file whenever there is a fast break, then it will lead to ledge formation or blocking one of the canal, and negotiating it further will be extremely difficult or in many instances impossible. The presence of root canal calcifications is more complicated than the presence of a pulp stone. In this radiograph, the distal canal of mandibular third molar is calcified. This often poses a lot of difficulties in canal negotiations and in obtaining canal patency. root canal calcifications will always appear more radiopaque, and in many instances, no differences between the root canal dentin and the root canal calcifications can be made. That is, simply there will be no evidence of a root canal present inside the roots. The reason why the root canal treatment is often complicated is because of the presence of root canal curvatures. Root canal curvature can obtain in two regions, the coronal and the apical. Dentists are often afraid of looking into the apical curvatures, but often the curvature which gives problem for the dentist while doing root canal treatment is not the apical curvature, it is the coronal curvature. The presence of coronal curvature often leads to instrument separation and not the apical curvatures. So anyhow, whether it is apical or coronal, careful attempt should be made by the dentist to create a proper glide path before using rotary instruments, and careful attempt should be taken to use new instruments whenever there is a presence of root canal curvature. When handled correctly, the presence of curvature is not a problem or it's not a hindrance for doing root canal treatment. Curvatures are always present, whether it is visible in a radiograph or not. A curvature should be always expected by the dentist and assumed that the tooth is having a root canal curvature. A proper preoperative diagnosis of the pulpal and the periapical status is essential before initiating root canal treatment. In this radiograph, in the second molar, the distal root, we can see a periapical radiolucency that correlates with the presence of a deep dental caries. We could consider that the tooth is non-vital. Maybe the pulp is necrotic and there is a presence of periapical radiolucency. Also, we can see that in the mesial root of first molar, there is a initial periapical radiolucency, or we can say that there is a widening of periodontal ligament space in the apical end. So this should be evaluated because this gives an idea whether we would go for a single visit root canal treatment or a multiple visit root canal treatment, what type of intracanal medicament we are going to use for this specific tooth. And it also gives some ideas about the prognosis or the success of root canal treatment in those tooth. Often neglected but very important is noticing the tooth angulations in the radiograph. If you see the tooth angulation or the angulation of the root canal from a location where we access the root canal from the coronal region, we can see that each tooth is having a different inclinations. Whenever the root canal is straight in the coronal 1/3, then we could assume that the root canal treatment can be fairly simple and easy. Whenever the straight angulation is tilted or deviated from a straight line, then often it is going to be quite complicated. If you see that the third molar, which is tilted mesially, and if you are accessing this root canal from a straight angulation, often it will lead to instrument separation. So the tooth angulation should be taken into consideration, and carefully all the radiographs should be observed for the presence of angulations. One of the hidden feature in the radiograph, which is often omitted and not known by most dentists and foreseen by the endodontist, is the pulpal floor to CEJ relationship. We can always consider that the orifices can be located at the level of cemento-enamel junction, that is at the cervical region of the tooth. It also gives some ideas that whenever we are preparing an access cavity, the burr should be measured and the burr should never be used to cut deeper more than the level of the CEJ. So the burr depth inside the access cavity preparation can be easily noticed from a radiograph, and also with correlating it with the clinically to the CEJ level. So as a golden rule of thumb, it should be always kept into our mind that the burr should never be used to cut more than the level of CEJ or the cervical level of the tooth. Root canal anomalies are much more common than what we think. In this radiograph, between the mesial and the distal root of the first molar, you can see a faint root. That is the extra root, which is called as the radix. If the extra root appears in the distolingual level, then it is called as radix endomolaris, and if it appears in the mesiobuccal region, then it is called as radix paramolaris. In this example, it is a radix endomolaris. Often these extra roots are missed, and it is one of the most important reasons for failure of root canal treatment. Two or more angulated radiographs should be always taken preoperatively, and it should be evaluated properly before initiating root canal treatment. One of the most omitted area which is often overlooked in a radiograph is the cervical lesion, which will lead to a shadow which overlaps the pulp chamber in radiographs. In this hypothetical example, we can assume that there is a class 5 deep caries in the third molar. Often class 5 lesions are very common in case of third molars because of limited accessibility of oral hygiene maintenance in the buccal surface of third molars. Whenever there is a decay in the third molar or any tooth in the cervical region, it often overlaps with the pulp chamber. As it overlaps with the pulp chamber, it is often hidden and it is often not noticed. But in this example, it is often very clear that there is a cervical lesion, and which could be one of the reasons for pain in this patient. Cervical abrasion also look as a shadow in the pulp chamber region or close to the cervical region of the tooth. The quality of the treatment and the presence of secondary caries or fracture in the existing restoration should be always evaluated. In this radiograph, we could see there is a presence of secondary caries, so that secondary caries could be one of the reasons for the pain in this patient. Whenever there is a problem in the existing restoration, then it is always ideal to replace the restoration at the earliest. As we plan to do root canal treatment, we often see only the tooth. But it is essential that we should open our eyes and see what is there beyond or out of the tooth. In this example, we can see there is a big bone loss between the second and third molars. And this could be caused because of the decay in the third molar, letting the foot getting impacted between the second and third molars, leading to a bone loss. It's not only doing a good root canal treatment, we should also take this bone loss or the periodontal status of the tooth into consideration before initiating root canal treatment. In a radiograph, we should always assess the status of the periodontal ligament. In case of ankylosis, the periodontal ligament space will be totally absent. In case of apical periodontitis or the initial stages of the periapical infection, there will be a widening of the periodontal ligament space, especially in the apical region. In case of periapical abscess, even if there is no apical or periapical radiolucency, but there will be always a widening or a uniform widening of the periodontal ligament space. Periodontal ligament space widening is also a finding when there is overload given to any specific tooth. Before initiating root canal treatment, we should also pay little attention to the nearby anatomic structure. For a mandibular tooth, we should always pay attention to the mental foramen and also the inferior alveolar canal. And for a maxillary tooth, we should always pay attention over the maxillary sinus. There are many case reports where the pushing intracanal medicament like calcium hydroxide beyond the apex will lead to paresthesia of inferior alveolar nerve. So inferior alveolar canal should also be taken into consideration while evaluating a radiograph before doing root canal treatment. So now, we can come to our final decision. What could be the reason for pain in this patient? It could be because of the secondary caries, which is close or approximating the pulp chamber space in the first molar, and also there is a apical widening in the mesial and the distal roots of first molar. So that could be one of the reason for the pain. Or in the second molar, there is a deep dental caries with periapical radiolucency in the distal root. That could be the reason for the pain. Or in the third molar, in the cervical region, there is a deep dental caries, and which might be involving the dental pulp, and that could also be the reason for the pain that the patient is reporting. So now you all will be able to notice the periapical lesions, the secondary caries, the extra radix root which is present, the inferior alveolar canal, and many other findings which you would have never seen when you saw this radiograph for the first time. I developed this radiograph just to put all the findings in a same radiograph. There could be some mistakes in the radiograph, but I will try to improve my work in the coming videos or in the coming presentations. Thanks a lot for watching this presentation. I will come back with more videos soon. Thank you for supporting me. Keep watching. Have a nice day.